According to the Talmud, the hydrolis was known, but it was not played in the temple. It was not one of these three instruments. Technical knowledge, how to build an organ prototype, was obvious before the hydrolis. Thank you. Magrepha was an object, or musical instrument, used in the Temple of Jerusalem, and is mentioned in the Talmud. It was used for, to signal a fixed order of the ceremony, by making a very loud sound, by whistling or throwing, the magrepha to the ground. Whether it was an ash shovel, a rake, or a musical instrument, is still the subject of debate today. Abraham Portelian described in his book a magrepha. Portelian forced the idea that the magrepha could have been an organ. Kircher writes that in the Bible a multi-string kithara existed before the flood, and that David used a 10-string psaltery. Kircher's source are the Talmud, rabbis, and Portelian. Probably the first illustration of the Mashrojitha. Thank you. Parker thinks that the megaphotamid could have been a bell. Quote by Kirker, Megaphotamid was a Talmudic musical instrument similar to our church organs. Prince copies Kirker's drawings, but changes the number of pipes and the position of the sliding keys. Prince also changes the drawing of Kirker's Megrapha, adding holes, changing the size of the pipes, and drawing more sliding keys than pipes. John Hawkins adopts Kirker's description of the instruments, but Anne's Prince's modified drawing. Farmer points out that in the Old Testament, there is no mechanical wind-powered instrument described, like our organ. Farmer writes, "We can dismiss the Magrepha of Kircher once for all." sex, as the Bible was opposed to depicting men and objects of any kind. We have no reliefs or paintings to consult concerning the nature of the few instruments named in the Holy Script.